Dear competitive colleges, you cannot make this permanent. I am an advocate for a meritocracy. I've been on the forefront of stressing the need for nationwide standards that are good and let colleges decide how much or how little they want to conform to those standards when admitting a class of students. Many of you want to keep those standards. I want you to have them. Parents and kids of merit want there to be standards instead of the old-fashioned way. That's the PPP of primping, poise, and pedigree that helped kids up until the 1960s get in with very little merit. Or the future which is not a good one, of what you say about yourself, how you feel, has more weight than your knowledge and your accomplishments in high school. There's a way to still keep standards and avoid this mess. You, the colleges, who have plenty of space on weekends to offer ACTs and SATs, please do that, because those two agencies, which are your friends, they don't have reliable schools. High schools that cancel on a single incidence of COVID in their, not even that school necessarily. It could be in the elementary school, but the whole district is then required to close, no SAT. What's happened is that kids haven't had a chance to test. Kids of high merit can't show their merit to you. This year, you're probably going to have to accept without a lot of scores on your record. But please don't make this permanent. If you make this permanent to have no standard, you will end up hurting yourselves and the whole country. There's four types of kids who will attend what used to be competitive universities. Okay, yours is going to go down. You will get spoiled rich kids. Fine. You will get middle-class whiners whose parents manage to wheedle good grades out of kids that are kind of dim. You will get foreigners. That still is an appealing thing, and their tuition with it, so I get that. And you'll get less privileged kids, but not necessarily of merit. You'll get those who get by in a system of easy grades without backup. Where will the truly meritorious kids go 10 years from now? It ain't to your colleges. It probably won't even be to the United States. They will go to Germany. They will go to the UK. They will go to India. They will go to Japan. They will go to good institutions of higher learning to be with kids of merit. You need to keep a standard of merit. How you've assessed in the past has been generally quite good. The lack of SAT and ACT is crimping you who want to stay colleges of merit. You can help. Again, every Saturday morning, your big lecture halls are empty right now. Every Saturday afternoon, your cafeterias are generally empty right now. You can house an awful lot of local high schoolers. And at the same time, how about you can sell your college to those high schoolers who get comfortable with your campus? It's a great proposition. Please offer it to Janet in Iowa, the head of the ACT testing organization. Please offer it to the College Board, dim as they've been over the last few years. Maybe they will accept your proposals. You'll have widespread testing that is good right on your campuses and avoid the perils of a loss in the value of American higher ed.